Hey everyone, this is Chad from GadgetGuruHD.com, and in this video I'll be demonstrating how to connect multiple monitors to your MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, or any Mac laptop. The first thing you'll need, of course, is the MacBook itself. The one I'm using is the mid-2014 15-inch Retina MacBook Pro. It's super powerful and won't have any issues running multiple monitors. The first panel I'll be using is the Dell Up24 4K 4K monitor, and I actually just did a review on it, and I'll also link that in the description if you want to check it out. The second display I'll be running is a 1080p AOC 23-inch monitor. It's actually only $150 right now, and it's a great value display. Now here's where things can get a bit tricky. If both of your monitors have a DisplayPort, then you'll need two Thunderbolt displays, two DisplayPort cables. If neither of them support DisplayPort, then you'll need two HDMI, two HDMI cables, along with one Thunderbolt to HDMI video adapter cable. I know this can all sound a bit intimidating and confusing if you're not familiar with all of these terms, but I'll have all of these products linked in the description just in case you have trouble finding anything. In my case, the 4K monitor supports DisplayPort, so I'll go ahead and plug the Thunderbolt into the laptop and the DisplayPort into the monitor. The AOC doesn't support DisplayPort, so I'll plug an HDMI into the laptop and also to the back of the monitor. After everything is all plugged in, both monitors should be powered on and show the max display. If it doesn't, then you probably need to adjust the input settings to either HDMI or DisplayPort. So now that we have both monitors powered on and connected, we need to adjust how they're arranged. To do this, we'll go to our System Preferences, Display, and then Arrangement. As you can see here, each square is one of your displays, and the little rectangle at the top identifies which is your main monitor. You can move the squares around to make it possible to drag documents from one monitor to the next. You want to spend at least 5 minutes or so messing around with that in order to get the best experience possible. So that right there pretty much wraps up this video. Like I mentioned earlier, I'll have links to all the products I'm using in the description, and also I'll have a more in-depth step-by-step guide on my website, just in case anyone needs a bit more help. If you run into any issues, go ahead and leave a comment down below, but I can't promise that I'll be able to respond to everyone. The most surefire way to get a hold of me is on Twitter at GadgetGuruHD, so if you have any questions, feel free to tweet me over there. Anyway, I hope this video did help you all out, and if it did, be sure to give this video a huge thumbs up, and also subscribe. I'm Chad from GadgetGuruHD.com, and I'll see all of you next time.